Soumya, first to you, what is the expected, what is the budget estimate of GST collections and how does it compare with what we have done April to August?
See, as far as GST collections and also if you look into direct tax collection concerned, if we combine them together, I think we are looking at a shortfall of around 1 lakh crores, and the GST targets could be lower by I think around 50 to 55,000 crores, and rest could be in the direct tax proportion. But the good thing is that, which I can explain to you, is that that may not impact the headline fiscal deficit number, which is set at 3.3%.
Okay, we'll just come back to that 3.3% math in a minute, Soumya. But Mr. Dalal, if I could come to you, I mean, the total direct tax revenue target for this year was somewhere a little over, I think, 13 lakh crores. That's corporates and individuals put together. Now, what the advance tax numbers on the direct tax front have told us, that it's looking alarming. I think the growth is only some 6% versus a growth of 18% in the same 6 months period last year. Your thoughts on tax collections and whether we are going to miss the target by a large mile?
So, Surbhi, we all know that there is a slowdown in the economy. It's quite significant. And as you rightly said, it was about 13 lakh crores, comprising 7,65,000 odd crores for the corporate and about 5,69,000 for non-corporate, which is individuals, partnership firms, etc. And as you said, the growth has been about 6%. But if you look at the overall situation, whether it is NBFC, whether it is autos, whether it is real estate, whether it is textiles, whether it is exports, there has been a significant slowdown. So honestly, I am not surprised. But to reach anywhere near the targeted collection, the remaining two quarters, remember two installments of advance tax have happened, June 1 and the September 1. What is pending is the December and the March. But in order to get to the target, the next two installments have to grow by 27%. And honestly, Surbhi, I can't see that happening at all with the situation we are in. So I don't think the target itself would have been realistic, because if, when you did this in July, I think there was a sense that the economy is stalling, and it has. So I'm not sure. I don't think we will get there, frankly.
Okay. Well, similar question to you, Mani. Good morning. We are not even hitting 1 lakh crore every month. The last month, we only did 98,000 crore. So no question of meeting the target, which I think should be at least 1.13 lakh crore per month. Is there anything by way of better administration of e-way bills that the taxes can be better collected? Or do you agree with what Mr. Ketan Dalal is saying, that this is entirely a victim of growth?
I would actually, Lata Morning, be a little optimistic on this front because of two reasons. See, in GST, the lower collections are a function of two factors that have happened. First is obviously the slowdown that we all are aware. The other issue is last year when we kept reducing the rates, they were reduced on the understanding that the compliance base would increase significantly. And a taxpayer base increase in GST not only increases the GST collection, it also increases the income tax collection by effect. Now, unfortunately, the tax base has not grown commensurate to the reduction in rates. So every single product that we have in GST today is either at the same rate prevailing before, or in 80% of the products, it is lower than the earlier tax rates. But that has not helped the economy overall in terms of having more number of taxpayers getting registered, more number of taxpayers filing their returns. And therefore, I would be optimistic in thinking future GST collections have got a chance of growing above 1 billion per month, primarily because we are getting into invoice matching possibly from January itself. We are also getting into a new return format, which will make it essential that credit is granted only when the other person has paid the tax. So if some of the measures which they are planning to take are implemented sooner than later, I think GST collections at some stage, there would possibly be a deficit at the end of the year. But that is something which is because of a very high number which we have taken.
Okay. All right, let me now take it back to Soumya. Soumya, now both our tax experts are telling us that obviously it's quite dire on the revenue front. Then where is your optimism coming from that 3.3% can be met? And, you know, actually a bigger question is, some people will argue that should we actually loosen up a little bit? Should we actually look at a tax impetus, maybe on the income tax front itself, to get people to spend?
No, I think that's a question which we can address separately in terms of and what could be the policy response. But let me explain in the maths very shortly. I think the total shortfall in the collections as of today is running around rupees 1 lakh crores. It could be a little higher, but suppose we stick to the time being at 1 lakh crores. Now, the first thing is that the RBI surplus transfer has been 58,051 crores. Mm. So take out that. So that means that another 40 to 45,000 crore shortfall has to be met. Now, the issue in the budget is that there could be pro rata expenditure adjustment could be made. For example, if you take the case of Prime Minister Kishan, the total budgeted amount is 87,600 crore for 14.6 crore farmers in India. But if you look at the number of KCC cards, that is around 6.9 crores. So the number of farmers which you could reach this year digitally, assuming it is at 8 crores, I assume that it's good at least 1 crore higher than 6.9 crores. So that means that at 6,000 crores, it is 48,000 crores, which makes the savings of around 40,000 crore more. So that takes the figure close to 1 lakh crore. And even if I assuming, there is also the precedence of food subsidy bill as it happened last year being front loaded to next year. So even after this, there is a possibility that the food subsidy bill could be front loaded. So that amount could be around 15 to maybe 20,000 crores. So that makes the figure over 1 lakh crores. And finally, all these puzzles doesn't fall in place, there is always the possibility of expenditure rationalization. If you look into the history of the last 5 years, there has been instances where expenditure has been cut, capital expenditure, and it has been increased also. But hopefully we may not have to walk down that path. And possibly this type of expenditure rationalization in terms of pro rata adjustments could just do the trick in the current fiscal, apart from possibly front loading from food subsidy into the next year.
So basically you're expecting that the budget will be balanced because you are going to see not so much expenditure on the Kisan income Yojana, the transfer of income. That could be half of what was assumed, and there is a higher than expected RBI dividend. And there is a passing over of the food subsidy to next year. Because of these three reasons, you think that you can balance the budget. Correct?
Yes. So okay. Basically, these are some of the options which the government can play around.
Okay.
So there may be some. Yeah.
So the question really is, then there is fiscal space for a rate cut on GST?
That looks difficult because basically the government now have to decide whether this wants to go for a fiscal space on a rate cut of 50,000 crores, maybe for even if I take the example of auto, or you want to look into the consumption foregone. Remember that the last quarter the consumption foregone was around 1.5 lakh crores. So it's a choice between a rate cut, whether it can boost demand or a consumption decline, which the government can assuming to be temporary for this quarter and think that this could be a pass-through effect. So this is an entire call which the government has to take. And my little point on this table is that if the GST rate cut looks difficult, then a rate cut also from the monetary side could look a little difficult in stimulating demand. So it's an entire call which the government has to take in terms of balancing the fiscal.
So okay. You're saying if there is a GST rate cut, there cannot be a monetary policy rate cut. Is that what you're saying? Because there will be a fiscal deficit and therefore...
I mean, both are equivalent.
Okay. Okay. You can have one of the two, not both. Okay.
Yes. So that could be both P. Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so I'm going to ask...
Absolutely.
I'm going to ask Ketan now for this. Ketan, if they were to loosen the purse strings a little bit, what is a better cut? Direct taxes or indirect taxes, i.e. GST? On direct taxes, they've not even made the DTC report public as yet, which was talking about rationalization of income tax. And that's straight money in people's hands. That's a huge sentiment boost, isn't it?
Yes, but as Soumya mentioned, I think currently there are other considerations. The pressure on collections, the slowdown is obviously occupying the minds of the government. I think the DTC in any case will go through some kind of a review because I don't think it can come in the current form. Anyway, they have already said that it will not come in the form of a new act. but it will come by picking parts of it, but I hope they pick it holistically. On the point that you made, Surbhi, regarding the rate cuts, you know, what happened coincidentally was that in the budget, the highest rate went up to 42%, and 15 days later, the DTC had said something else. So I think that will need to be reconciled. Overall, if you ask me, both from a corporate tax standpoint and from an individual tax standpoint, I think the way to go would be to cut rates and to grow the pie, grow the economy, and get tax from that, as opposed to digging it, you know, sort of deep in a narrow silo. I think that's the way I'd look at it. A couple of other points I want to make. We are today in September, and I believe that in any case, refunds start getting squeezed and sort of held back. And my fear is that this year, you know, refunds will get held back, which again will not be good for industry, because they will, I suspect, hold back refunds to meet the target to whatever extent they can. The second point is neither the 42% rate nor the fact that people have not made any capital gains. So both of those may also to some extent have impacted the collection.
Okay. Mr. Dalal, you don't buy money's argument that because there is going to be better invoice matching, sheer better administration may improve collections?
Yes, Lata, that can happen to some extent. But you have to also look, you know, Soumya mentioned about auto. We all know about auto, you know, when you have a 50% drop in commercial vehicles and 40% in cars, as one example. You know, the administrative streamlining will certainly help to some extent. But when the size of the pie is shrunk and we do not see the clouds lifting on that, I don't think that that streamlining will move the needle that much for the current year. It may move it over a period of time. But I do not think we are talking about the tyranny of the year and the now. And from that point of view, I think it's a little doubtful whether it will move the needle too significantly, in my view, Lata.
Okay, well, by the way, those are interesting updates that our Delhi colleagues are sharing with us. It seems that Finance Ministry officials were at the PMO yesterday to discuss the measures that are likely to be announced in, 15, 16 minutes from now? 10:30 is the press conference, and then there is the GST meeting. It's a heavy Friday for sure. So, Mani, I'm going to ask you this. Now, of course, a lot of different sectors are clamoring for cuts. Mr. Rajiv Vijay saying, don't cut on auto. It really makes no difference. Then we heard that maybe on hotels, they'll start tweaking and change the threshold. So I don't know how, what is justified, what is not. But purely from a tax point of view, pre-GST era, post-GST era, if they are to rationalize anything, which should be the categories, the products, the services, or the commodities?
On majority of products, the rates that we have in GST today are far lower than they were in the pre-GST era, which is just 2 years old. And therefore, at this stage, when we have some challenges in growing the economy, possibly if a call is to be taken on which product the rate is to be cut, it should be those where the elasticity of demand is very, very high. So if a rate cut significantly improves the consumption or the buying or the spending, yes, it should. But all the products that you mentioned just now, you know, to me, the factors impacting those products are not in respect of the higher tax rate. The products are much deeper. And therefore, if there is a structural issue which is there for some sector, it could be at a global level, it could be at a national level.
Okay.
I think we need to address those issues rather than looking at tax cuts as a panacea for, you know, taking care of all the consumption issues.
Okay. Okay. Well, I take your point, but I'll still toss it to Soumya for one last time. Soumya, if there has to be a GST cut, where is the elasticity best? Any short list where a tax cut makes sense?
I think cutting GST, I am not sure whether cutting GST, the government will go ahead, because given the fiscal space is constrained. But if it were to cut GST, I think it could come, do it some of the low-value items. For example, some of the FMCG goods where it is possibly seeing some sort of a slowdown, where you could manage with the revenue and may not be going for rate cuts on items which could be of luxury consumption. So possibly there could be some sort of a rate cuts, but on items whereby the government could manage the revenue and it can see an immediate gain in terms of, small ticket items the government could consider.
Let's see what the government considers. Soumya, my last question has got nothing to do with taxes, but just guessing what's coming up next. On divestment, in your math of 3.3%, What's the realistic, you know, receipt number that you penciled in? We don't know if they're going to announce something on strategic divestment at 10:30 or not, but just to get the numbers in place.
No, I think the divestment experience last year when we had, I think we had exceeded, and I am very hopeful that this target of this year, I think 1.5 lakh crores this year also will be met, because the government has been very particular in looking at various options, cross-subsidization, and also the Indian Airlines. I think the Air India is also coming up shortly in terms of whether it could be sold. So on that front, I am not so, I believe that the target could actually be met on the disinvestment front.
Okay.
So my worries are on the tax front.